members of the NWO have been out here repeatedly to accept challenges, to make statements, and to wrestle. And right now, Kurt Hennig, along with Rick Rude, makes his way out to the ring. And gentlemen, before this match gets underway, a couple of things we need to say. WCW comes to Fort Myers on Tuesday, April 7th. That's Fort Myers, Florida. Wednesday, April 8th, will be in Fort Pierce, Florida. Friday, April 10th, the Civic Center, Montgomery, Alabama. And Saturday, April 11th, the UTC Arena in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Tickets for all these events go on sale this Friday, the 13th, at the box offices and all usual outlets for WCW in the month of April.
But you better get them early.
You better get them early is right. That's been the theme here. WCW tickets, wherever we go, have been a prized commodity.
Just like Winston-Salem this evening, another sellout capacity crowd. And has there ever been a more appropriate venue for a matchup with Kurt Hennig and the Nature Boy Ric Flair than Winston-Salem, North Carolina? Uh-huh. The same city, the same building where Kurt Hennig turned his back on WCW, the Four Horsemen, and this man, the Nature Boy.
You know, you're right. And that's a point, Mike, that you brought up. That needs to be talked about, and it's something we didn't bring up. It was here at Fall Brawl in the Double Cage when Kurt Hennig became a member of the New World Order. We thought Ric Flair's career was over. As a matter of fact, the very next night, we came in to Charlotte, North Carolina. I thought we had seen the last of Ric Flair, but great athletes do not go down easily. Ric Flair is back, and Ric Flair will go into the match against Kurt Hennig to try to settle a personal score here in this arena.
Just think of all the personal scores we have here tonight. Flair Hennig, Steiner Brothers, and that six-man tag.
For Winston-Salem, for WCW, and for every horseman that ever walked the aisle, buddy.
Well, don't sell Kurt Hennig short, along with Rick Rude. That's not Charlie Channon, number one son out there.
No, and I think Flair realizes that. You wouldn't be a 13-time world champ by taking your opponents lightly, Brain.
You know, and Rude and Hennig go back to school days. They've been together a long time, and when one gets in trouble, the other one helps. History.
Same old NWO story as well. Be interesting to see in that six-man tag who will help whom. All right, the match gets underway here, and Kurt Hennig starts with a shoulder takedown, and Ric Flair out of the ropes. Bails him out of the center of the ring.
And Hennig bails out for a conference with Rude.
You know, this is a great tactic employed by Hennig here. He knows Flair has the momentum in this arena. He's trying to slow that momentum down. Flair, though, is trying to keep the tempo going. Pulls him back in the ring. The trademarks of Ric Flair. Those backhand knife-edge chops that are so loud, ringing out in venues across the world. He sends Hennig down again.
When Hennig and Flair get in there, they're two veterans. They've both been there too many times. You're not going to outsmart the other guy. It's just going to be the winner of this match is going to be who's the dirtiest. You're not going to trick Flair in anything. Or Hennig.
Sends Flair into the corner. Does Hennig back body drop? Oh, Flair hit very hard that time. Great elevation on a back body drop by Hennig. He stalks Flair into another corner. Oh, Kurt Hennig with knife edge chops of his own.
The wrestler that made Minnesota famous.
Ric Flair, that's right. They had Ric Flair Day not too long.
No. Kurt told me that about himself.
Well, he's a liar and you're a believer. Into the corner. Up the top. Down to the floor goes Ric Flair.
Yeah, Hennig has always claimed to be the greatest athlete ever produced by the state of Minnesota.
And now Rude. Flair shoulder first to the ring post.
Didn't he have an operation on that shoulder a while back?
Yes, he did. A shoulder injured at the hands of who else? The NWO. Think about the injuries. Think about the numbers of injuries and men in the hospital and careers that have taken turns at the hands of members of the New World Order.
Well, the recurring image that I have is those close-up shots of Ric Flair's face as he was being wheeled into surgery the day after. Well, the last time we were here in Winston-Salem. Now it's payback time.
Hennig absorbs those, and now it's toe-to-toe in the corner. Flair and Hennig, back and forth they go. Who's going to get the advantage? It's Hennig, swinging wildly. Flair just stood there, waited for an opening, and chopped him down. What a veteran move that was, guys.
Just backed up a half step and waited for Hennig to make a mistake. Just like that. And Hennig don't make many mistakes. Shows you how good Flair is.
He points at Rude, points at the referee, gets the attention one way, and then drop kicks the man into oblivion on that one.
I think that one was for the Four Horsemen.
Well, I think that one was for many of us. Ric Flair. I mean, Flair has mounted quite an offensive flurry here. Another beat that time to the other corner. Ric Flair has Hennig all the way over. What's he doing now?
Where's he going?
Going hunting for a chair.
He's going for a weapon here. He's got the chair in the ring. Flair is wrestling this match, guys, with purpose. He's got Hennig upside down, tied up.
And remember, Hennig's the one that slammed the cage door on his head.
And Flair will never forget that. Chair against the face. The fans are standing. They love it here. Rude stomping around the ring. NWO's come in.
See, just when Flair wanted to answer with a little steal to the face of Hennig.
Did Rude blindside him?
The referee asked him for the bell. This one's over.
You know what he was going to do? He was going to put that chair right on the face of Curt Hennig and stop him and break his nose.
He's going to take him out is what he was going to do. And that enables now members of the NWO to triple team or the triple team. Oh, my.
And Rude's got the chair.
Rude's got the chair. Hennig has Ric Flair up. Now they're going to hook Flair.
Team effort.
Team effort. They're going to hook him to that top turnbuckle. And Hennig's going to try to do the same thing here.
Oh, not again.
The fans erupt again. The cause. Brett, the Hitman Hart. Out of nowhere. Has come in.
Flair came to help him recently. So one hand washes the other.
And Bret Hart and Curt Hennig to go at it this Sunday. One on one. They're not waiting. They're going at it now.
There's the Hitman hitting at his best.
That's what he's doing. The fight goes on. We've got to step out on Nitro.
Don't go away.
Oh, we'll be back.
No. I'm going down there.